Hey guys, Vikas over here, and this is UR Genius. Guys, today I am with a new video. We'll check out the new Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module. And in this video, we'll see the specs of the module, configure using the web interface, and we'll access the terminal using SSH. And you can say the Linkit Smart 7688 Duo module is a tiny little controller that can be used for your IoT projects. So, being said that, let's get started, guys. Now coming onto the board, this comes in two flavors, and those are Linkit Smart 7688 and Linkit Smart 7688 Duo. And over here, what I am having is the Duo module. And the difference between both is that Duo features an Atmega 324 controller apart from the main MPU, which can be programmed using Arduino. Checking out the board, on the front side, you get two micro USB sockets, out of which top one acts as an USB host so that you can connect any USB devices to it. The second one is for providing power to the module, which can be connected to any USB power source. In between the USB sockets, it has two LEDs which shows the power source status and as well as Wi-Fi status. The Wi-Fi LED also shows system status, like if it is acting as an access point or it is in station mode. After that, we get three text switches, which are for MPU reset, Wi-Fi reset, and MCU reset. In front side, most of the area is covered by the shield, which hides the MPU below it, which is the empty 7688 MIPS 24KEC controller having Wi-Fi and Ethernet stack, and it is clocked at 580 MHz. It also features 120 MB of DDR2 RAM. And after that, on the front side, we also get the chip antenna for Wi-Fi, and as well as we get one IPX connector, which can be used if you want to add your own high gain antenna. Now coming to the back side of the controller, it features micro SD card socket, which you can use for your micro SD card, and the Atmega 324 microcontroller for Arduino, which is clocked at 8 MHz. In the back side, you can also see the 32 MB of flash memory chip. And coming onto the GPIOs, which are exposed edge mail headers from the module, they feature 27 GPIO, 12 ADC with 3.3 volt support, 8 PWM pins, 1 I2C port, 1 SPI port, 8 external interrupt pin, 3 UART light ports. And if you want to go into details, like detail about the pins and the pin diagram, I'll leave a link down below in the description for the SID Studio website, where you can find more details about the GPIOs. So that's all about the module, and let's connect the power supply to it, and we'll get back to the PC and we'll configure the module from our PC. So guys, after powering up your Linkit module, and the red LED present on the Linkit module that shows the Wi-Fi connection goes off nearly about glowing for 30 seconds, we are good to go. Now under Wi-Fi section of our PC, we can see some SSID that starts with Linkit Smart. Now to connect to the module, we can click on this and straight away click on connect, and you are not required to enter any password because it is not password protected. So it will take some time, depends. And when it is connected, you can see your Wi-Fi LED on the Linkit module will start blinking. Like it will blink for 3 times with pause of 0.5 second. Now you can straight away go ahead to any web browser that you are using, and we can type in mylinkit.local. But to make it work, you just need to install Bonzer Print Services to your system if you are using Windows. So as I have already installed, I don't need to install it. But if you have not installed it, you can simply go ahead and download it and you can install it automatically. So now getting into the link, just type in mylinkit.local, and this might be required for the first time only, because if your like Linkit module is configured as station mode and you know the IP address of the like Linkit module, you can certainly go ahead with that. But if you are configuring it for the first time, it is pretty much required unless you are connected using the serial console. Now when you log in for the first time, it will ask you to set a password. So there is no default password, so I'll just set in a password for me. Now After setting up the password, we just need to enter the password so that we can log in. Now you will be presented with a page that looks something like this. Like, you'll have system information as well as network information. As I said earlier, it is currently in access point mode. So if you want, you can make it into station mode, which will be doing. But let's have a look at system information. It shows you the device name, the current IP address it is having, and again your username, by default username, that is root, and the password, the software versions, and if you want to make it a factory site. Now over here we can upgrade the firmware, and for that we'll just need the right firmware file for that. So what we'll do is, we'll not be updating from here. Instead, we'll get into the terminal by using SSH, and we'll try to update there only. Now getting into the network, I'll just configure it into station mode so that I can access it easily without requiring to have a one-to-one connection, and it will be connected to my own network. Now just select the Wi-Fi network that you want to connect it to, then configure and restart. And as you can see over here, it says the state of Wi-Fi LED when it is connected to the network. Okay, now click on OK, and again you need to enter your password. Now one more thing, to have internet access on my network, I need to have a static IP, otherwise it will not work. So to set a static IP, let's get into the advanced configuration, that is the OpenWRT page. And over here again, you need to insert your password, and you'll be presented with the OpenWRT web interface. And you'll get whole lot of configurations over here. So if you want any particular things to be changed, you can change over here. And under wireless, you'll find your connections and all. So I'll just straight away get into one address, and I'll just change it to static. Static address, switch protocol. And click on save and apply. Now coming on to other configurations, you get status, typically shows the status of the module itself. You can get into system, and you can change host name, the time zone, etc. I'm not going to change over here. Then you can change the LED configuration. See, I can run some scheduled tasks like a cron tab. So it shows the script, those runs when it starts up. Go administration, you can enable SSH and all. Then getting into, you can have backup of flash firmware. Then get into services. Shows all those media streaming and all. Network shows all lot of network configurations that is currently there. You can have DHCP, DNS, all those things. We are not getting into it, but if you are interested in those, you can simply go for OpenWRT Wiki, and you can see what we can configure, like how we can configure this and what stands for what. And getting into system, let's see what are the different modules those are installed by default. Yeah, over here it shows the different modules, those are already there with the OpenWRT. So if you are interested in other services or other packages instead of this, whatever listed over here, you can go ahead and install by using OPKG. And that is using the SSH terminal only, and that's the default package manager in case of OpenWRT. Now let's close this out, and we'll try to have a SSH connection, and we'll try to update the firmware of the module, and we'll try to blink the Wi-Fi LED by using some Panther script that is already there in the boot. So just click on reboot so that it will take the static IP address. Now just wait till your Wi-Fi LED, that is a red LED present on the board, starts blinking. Yep, we are good to go. Now open up any terminal application that you are having, but I am going with putty only. So I'll just give a link down below in the description. So if you are interested, you can download it. Type in the IP address and click on open. Yeah, click on yes. Type in the username, password that you have set, and it will be presented with a terminal like this. So now let's try to update. But before that, I'm just checking if I am having an internet connection over here. Pinging google.com. It is saying network is unreachable. So I'm adding the gateway manually to my network interface, and let's see if you are having an internet connection. Yep, right now we are having an internet connection. So we'll first try to update the firmware on the Linkit module. So to do that, I'll use OPKG, then update. And as I said, OPKG is the default package manager present on Linkit module, or that is as it is running upon WRT. So wait for some time till it gets completed, and it did finish. So now let's try to upgrade. We can't do upgrade for all packages, so instead we need to do it for individual packages, and as I am new to this OpenWRT, I'm not aware of that. But I went through some blogs and they say it is not recommended to have an upgrade. Instead, you should reflash the module or the Linkit module over here, or any module that is running OpenWRT with the latest firmware. So don't run this upgrade command, it is not required right now. Just after OPKG update, you are good to go. Now let's try to check out some default Python scripts that is already there with this module, and that will let us blink the Wi-Fi LED that is present on the board. So to do that, I get into the folder cd/IoT. And over here you'll find some files, and our interest is on blinkgpio44.py. So we'll just have a look onto that file and see what is the exact script. Okay, this is simple script that is importing two packages, MRA and time. Time is used to provide a delay in between blink or the on and off state. Then using MRA, it is accessing the pins, and it has first configured taken out the pin, then it has configured it as output, and it is writing 1 and 0 after some delays. So let's exit from this and we'll try to run this script and see if we are able to blink the LED. So to exit, type in Q and information, and to run the file just type in Python then blink gpio44.py, and let's see if we are able to blink the Wi-Fi LED. And as you can see, the Wi-Fi LED has started blinking. So guys, that's all for today, I hope you have liked this video. If so, hit the thumbs up button. And I hope I'll be coming with more videos around this tiny little IoT board. So again, if you have not subscribed to my channel, you can definitely subscribe to it for videos like this. So see you next time with my next video. Till then, goodbye.